What the hell? That's not a name I recognize. Oh. There we go. I don't know. Kinda tired. Let's play some Fractured Space. I don't even know how this looks. I don't even know how this looks, man. I hope it looks good. People other than me are gonna have to tell me, because it's kind of silly for me to watch my old stream while I'm streaming. I can go back and look at the VOD, but that's it. Woo!
Delicious Coca-Cola.
The preferred choice of caffeination in the Empire.
Oh! Oh!
Yes! No, maybe? Maybe. I don't know. How many people do we even have playing right now? Probably at this time of night, or night, morning, day, not terribly many. Let's see. Ah, 900-ish people. That's not bad. I'm probably gonna be in queue for a little bit, but whatever. Whatever! That's alright. And if it's not alright, then... tough. I don't have another choice. I mean, unless I want to go and play, like, bots. And I don't really want to... I'm okay with bots, I just don't want to play bots right now. Don't want to play bots right now. Don't want to play bots right now. I want to play against some people. It's been a long time since I've played at this particular time of day. Hey, Impact, how you doing? How are things? All this platinum, and I've already spent some of it, and I bought the Typhoon, so I have all the ultimate skins, yeah! I don't have all the skins. Because a bunch of these are in bundles. Or, like, all of these are in bundles, pretty much. Yeah, like, what? Hold on. What of this do I actually own? Okay, I own both of these. Red October. I only don't own one of these, which is a little silly. Hera. This is gonna be one I'm gonna have to get once I'm actually able to. And I'm still missing two pieces from this. Oh, I've got the Executioner bundle. And I know I've only got one thing out of the Purple Rain bundle. Right there. Right there! I don't even know. I am so tired right now. It is just now 6 in the morning. And I get to go into work tomorrow. So it's really weird, 'cause I was on for 2 days this week. And then next week, our work weeks start on Thursday for some reason. I don't fucking know. Next week, I'm on 3 days. So I worked Tuesday, Wednesday, off Thursday, Friday, go back to work on Saturday, then I'm off Sunday, Monday, then back on Tuesday. Supposedly, we've got a really busy weekend this week. Although, I'm expecting, once a coworker of mine sees that I will be there on Saturday, she will not show up. Because she doesn't like me very much. She doesn't like anybody. Also, nobody likes her. But whatever, she's a crotchety old witch. I'd ask how everything looks, but I mean, so far I haven't done anything like particularly action-packed, so it's not like I've stressed the image quality so far. But the video quality between last stream and this stream, I went from a 1300 bit rate to a 2000 bit rate. I don't know if it's sustainable, seeing as I'm not partnered or anything, but I'm giving it a shot. So please, you guys, once we actually get into the game, Let me know how it looks. Cause I actually have a lot more headroom for streaming or for quality, but unless you're a partner and you have transcoding, I'm basically as high as you want to go right now. Man, I wish I had transcoding. That would be super awesome. But I don't. Oh well. They used to actually hand out transcoding if you got up to 30-ish concurrent viewers. Back in my War Thunder days, I would actually be able to reach that on a... So how do you get to be a partner? Okay. The way you get to be a partner is... The official way is you have to have an average of like 400 concurrent viewers before they will even consider you. That's actually not true. You have to be in a position where enough people are watching you that Twitch thinks that they will make money. Because that's what they're a business at the end of the day. They are a business. They want to make money. So if they think they can make money off of you, they'll do it. I think you also have to have been streaming for longer than like 3 months or 6 months or something, and I mean I've got that beat many times over. You have to stream, I think it's at least 3 times a week. 2 or 3 times a week, something like that. That's just the official stance and stuff, but really it's people have to think, they have to think they're gonna make money off of you, right? Because there's one streamer slash YouTuber guy who only does it as a hobby. Axagoras, how you doing? But he only some of you guys might know him. Is Carl Sagan 42? He does Mario Maker stuff, and he only streams like once a week maybe. But he gets like over 2,000 concurrent viewers or something crazy like that. And he's partnered. So, I mean, at the end of the day, it's... Does Twitch think they could make money off of you? Because what they're going to be doing is they're going to be taking a cut of your subscribers. It's New Pants Day? New Pants Day? I haven't bought new pants in ages. Actually, no, the last time I bought pants was over a year ago, and it was specifically for my job at the used car dealership. That was the last time I bought new clothes. I should probably go and buy new clothes. That might not be a bad idea. I could definitely use with more. Definitely do with more pants. Them bracket 4Q times. Alright, we're over 5 minutes. By quite a bit, so we're gonna restart it. Actually, hold on. Okay. Yeah, I'm tired as shit. Man. I hope we actually get games. Because I know there's people playing. I also know that I'm just kind of... I'm stuck in bracket four. I'm stuck in ELO hell. Oh, everybody is so bad and I'm like the best. Ugh. Pro tip. Every ELO is ELO hell. Why? Because everybody thinks they're better than they actually are. Even me. Belt loadout option? Yep. Yep. I can understand your pain there. But kind of in an opposite way. I'm one of those annoying shits who like can eat whatever the fuck he wants and not gain weight. Sorry, it's not my fault. But that also means that finding pants for me is kind of a bitch and a half. Because I have, like, a very tiny waist. If you'd like to come along, Impact, you can come along for your free game of the day. But yeah. I'm too skinny, so it's hard to shop. In this land of excessive fucking waist lengths. I and my mutant ability to inhale whatever garbage I feel like and not gain weight makes it very hard for me to get pants. It is difficult for me to find pants. On occasion, I just go on without them, and people stare. I can't really blame them. I look like a crazy person stalking around outside with my long hair and my beard and my crazy eyes and no pants. Under 30 waist. I'm right at that. My comfort level is... My pants that I'm wearing... My jeans that I'm wearing right now, which I've had these forever. These are 29s. These are 29-inch waists. And I mean... It would take a lot of effort, but I could potentially pull these off. As in, pull them... I could pants myself. It would require a fair amount of pulling. Hey, Rez. But it could happen. So, yeah. I'm too thin for my own good. I need to eat more sandwiches. Or I could just deal with it.
deal with it.
That's enough of that. I wear my sunglasses at night. So I can. What? Huh? Who? References to songs I don't really know the words to. Stop.
Stop it.
Man, I wish I was cool. I wish I was cool enough to pull deal with it off. But I actually like my little blue X. I like it. It's pretty fucking cool. There was another guy I knew. Song as old as me? Probably. Hold on, let's find out. Sunglasses at night. Released 1984. This song is 3 years older than me. Sunglasses at night. January 21st, 1984. So it is three and most of a fourth year older than me. Because I'm November of 87. So February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Yeah. So it's 3 years and 10 months older than me. That means it's over 30. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, I just thought about it again. I'm gonna be 30 in 13 months. Yeah. I'm gonna be 30 in 13 months. I haven't accomplished a damn thing. I still feel like I'm fucking in high school. Shit. Plans? No. I don't have any. Maybe I'll do a special stream. That's it. That's really it. I don't have any kind of plans. I mean, seriously, my time is going to be spent going, "Dear God, I'm 29, I haven't accomplished a damn thing with my life. What am I doing?" Because really, I thought, you know, if you'd asked me where I would have been 10 years ago, I would have thought I would have been somewhere crazy awesome by now. Crazy awesome by now. I have midlife crisis now. Well. Your life isn't over. Your life's never over until you're done. Right? And I'm not done. I just, you know, would have thought I would have been someplace else by now. Would have thought I'd have been someplace else a little bit more interesting than here. Although, I tell you what. Hey, Raiden. I tell you what. I could be in a lot worse places. I really could be in a lot worse places than I am right now. I mean, I like streaming. It's a lot of fun. I need to figure out a way to do more with it. Got some ideas. But we'll see. 'Cause I really need to. If I'm going to use this stream in and accomplish what I would like to accomplish with it, to be perfectly frank, I need to have more people watching me. I need to get stable job type thing. I need to have some sort of stable income so I can not starve. I need to have the weekends off so I can stream. Oh my god, we've got a game! Stream when everybody's available. Everybody. When there are more people available to watch. And I need to attract more people. Because while, yes, I enjoy streaming, I do not really want to turn streaming into my job. If streaming is part of it, kick ass. Totally cool with it being part of it. But I don't want to be, like, a professional streamer. I would like to end up in the gaming industry somewhere. Ideally at ECG, but, I mean, pipe dreams. Shed no tears. I'm broken down on a Halifax pier. The last to bear its part of the tears. Alrighty. Is that the new bitrate? I have gone from a 1300 bitrate to a 2000 bitrate. So things should be a fair bit clearer. I mean, yeah. I mean, really? If I maxed it, I could have like a 3800 bitrate, which wouldn't be good at all. That would make Twitch's servers puke on me. Might want to try some other games. Hi Kim, welcome to the stream, and I will not be trying other games. I've been with Fractured Space since Technical Alpha. I mean, Fractured Space, I have known that Fractured Space was going to be something special from the very first moment that I started playing it. Maybe not a runaway success, but let's be perfectly honest, nobody is League of Legends, nobody is World of Warcraft until they are, right? That's kind of just something that happens when you get the convergence of just a whole bunch of lucky happenings, right? Right place at the right time. But I'm with Fractured Space.
Had no tears.
And I have no plans of leaving. I have no plans of changing. Yes, I will take breaks on occasion. But I'm staying. Fuck going anyplace else. Alright. I don't wanna go someplace else, really. I like Fractured Space too much. I legitimately like Fractured Space. Fractured Space is amazeballs, which is one of the reasons I really want to stick with it. Because I don't have to fake my enthusiasm for it, right? If I stream pretty much anything else, I have to fake enthusiasm. And I don't have to do that with Fractured Space, which is amazing. Amazing. I like it too much. Alright, Kurt. Okay, so Kurt's pretty good. But he's in a healer. So, he is going to be able to positively influence his team, but not as much as he potentially could. Woo! In a DPS ship. Oh! Little happy little boozer. Alright. Oh, this is not good. Yep. Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all. There's no fake enthusiasm that day? No, there wasn't. So I'm like, they have that much money to market it, like, take off, or it won't. Make a living out of a game with small player base. That's the thing, Kim. I'm not, at least for me, I am not looking to make a living out of streaming, specifically. I'm using streaming as, one, something fun to do, because I enjoy it. But two, as a means of getting to a potential job in the industry somewhere. I'm still a lot farther away from that than I would like to be, but God damn it. Alrighty. But yeah. Alright, one of the reasons I'm so keen on Fractured Space is I really do want to work with the guys at Edge Case. When I went over there to meet them, they were all really cool. They all legitimately like the game. Protagonist specifically is a really, really smart guy, and I feel like I have a lot to learn from him. I have a lot to learn, period. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, wait. No. Okay, we're gonna switch lanes. It's about to hurt. Alrighty. I thought he was about to beam me, but he didn't. He could have. He could have tripped me up quite a bit there. But yeah, I mean, maybe if you want to get down to it, I haven't picked the best game for doing anything with, but there's a lot to be said for going after something that you like, that you think is worth it, right? Rather than lying. And that's a big thing to me right now. That's a big thing for streamers in general, right? If you want to be a successful streamer, you need to be enjoying yourself. Because if you're not, your audience is gonna know. And if your audience knows that you're not having a good time, they're not gonna have a good time, and that's bad for everybody. And they're not gonna watch. Thought you might want to make a living in streaming? No. This is a means to an end. Also a hobby. Alright, what I want to end up doing, at least I think what I want to end up doing, is I think I'd actually like to try my hand at being a publisher. And this is like way long term. I'd like to try my hand at being a publisher. I think, without going into too much detail, because I really don't want to, because it's not the most comfortable topic to talk about, gaming and playing games have enabled me to not do some things that I very much could not undo. And as such, it has, you know, it's become very important to me. It's given me a lot. And I want to be able to give back. And I think part of that needs to be finding people who have really awesome things that need to exist and enabling people to do those amazing things. Maybe that's totally not how it's going to end up, but that's the dream right now. That's the dream. If it ends up changing, then it ends up changing. I would very much like to actually hit the things that I'm aiming at. Okay. Son of a monkey! They got it. Oh, I hate shooting the raven. It's shaped like a pancake! That makes it difficult to hit! At the very top of the ship's aiming reticule is killing me. Got him! Get wrecked, nerd. I hate sentinels and their top and their bottom feeding. Oh my goodness. Oh, jeez. Ow. Oh dear. This is just a travesty. This is hardly ideal. Ooh. But yeah, they have a better comp than we do, I think. Or rather, I'm not very strong in the Leviathan. I picked it to be fun. I picked it to have fun. But That's kind of the double-edged sword of Bracket 4 is you pick something to try and have fun, but if you do that, you're potentially going to be impacting your ability to, you know, actually win the game, and to a lot of people, and including myself, winning is fun. I would very much like to know. There you are. Ah, slow down. Come on. And that bastard sentinel. I swear, smart guns on attack ships, smart guns on anything that isn't a support ship is incorrect. The only ship that I really am okay with it on is the, what's it called? The Raven. Because the main gun on that isn't meant to do damage. It does damage by nature of the fact that it is a weapon, But the point of it isn't to do damage. There we go. I should very much like to be able to move faster. Yep, and he's out. Sentinel! Remove yourself from my presence! Oh, you've got broken armor. That's right, piss off. There's a Colossus there. I'm probably about to die. It's actually really fucking bad. We're doing so horribly this game. We're doing so not good! Raven, piss off! You are the most annoying ship, I swear. We got shit on this game. Making games? What do you do? I actually don't... I want to end up in the administration side. I honestly have stuck my fingers into a lot of... or several different disciplines. I did programming in high school. I went to... 3D animation modeling was a heavy part of my college education. I was decent at the programming side, but, I mean, I ended up not having an interest in it. I take that back. My interest in programming was heavily influenced by the teacher that I had. And because when I went to college, I didn't have a professor with that level of enthusiasm, I dropped it. And I ended up not going anywhere with it. It was interesting stuff, to be sure, but not something I saw myself doing long term. And then to be perfectly frank, at 3D modeling and animation, I just fucking sucked. Like, I was not even good. Not even kind of. I was good enough at the basics to be a teacher's assistant for it. But that's only because I was able to wrap my head around the basics. Pretty easy. Other than that, haven't really done anything. I mean, I've read a lot about design in specific titles. I mean, I like talking about stuff specifically with, there we go. There, oh, you. Sentinel! Fuck you. I want you to die. Gojira? Yes! Actually, thank you very much for introducing me to them. X, because my appreciation for them has grown. I actually happen to like them quite a bit right now. Ah, he's out of my
No!
Ah, well. French technical death metal? Is that what this is called? Technical? Alright, I like this. But yeah, anyway. But yeah, as for, like, actually making games, to be perfectly frank, I don't really want a hand in the general day-to-day, that kind of thing. Honestly, if I got full pipe dream mode, full and complete and utter pipe dream mode right now, if everything was to go perfectly, just exactly the way I wanted it to. And let's be honest, it won't. ECG will continue to be more and more successful with Fractured Space. It may, more than likely not a runaway hit, but again, like I was saying before, nobody is League of Legends or World of Warcraft until they are. But I kind of would like to end up as maybe CM, or ACM, rather, with a focus on helping the competitive side, since I really enjoy the commentating. And if they actually do it, and I suspect they would, because it's pretty common for MOBAs, join the, like, in-house balance testing side of QA. I mean, I'm not, like, mega pro or anything, but I'm decent at the game. But that would be, that's, like, the dream maximum full bore. Oh my god, this is everything I ever wanted. Or at least I think I wanted. Of course, if I end up being good at something and it needs to be done, fuck yeah, I'll go for it. No shame. Okay. That's a dead healer. Come on. But yeah, that's maximum pipe dream mode. I don't expect that to happen. Other than that, I kind of, to be perfectly frank, if that ends up not happening, what I'd like to do is I'd like to end up in a CM/QA role somewhere for a title that I can not lie about being interested in. I realize that's a luxury, but, you know. Maybe like the Mass Effect series or something like that. I don't know. I'd have to actually get down to Austin before even thinking about any, like, work in Austin. But that would be option two, is to save up money, go down to Austin, find something there. I mean, I'm more than happy to start really low on the totem pole in general. I spending as much time around Fractured Space as I have, I've really come to appreciate what QA do, even though I know really just the barest sliver of the depth of it. Couple of people for the ME3 ending. Well, see, that's the thing. I'd be tempted to do that as well, but we have imaginations for a reason. But yeah, ended up somewhere like that. But these days, you either have to know somebody. You need to know somebody in order to get in anywhere these days, pretty much. Or you need to be so ballsing amazing that you just completely blow people away. I was wondering what I was going to spend on this platinum on. Now I remember what I was going to spend on this platinum on. Boosters! 360-day booster. Fuck yes. Platinum, gone. That's $50 of platinum. Gone. I went and bought the Typhoon because I didn't own it, and now I have 360 days worth of boost left. Yeah! And yes, I know that sometimes I'm attempting to do that for a living, but it really would only be temporary. My ultimate goal is not to be a streamer. It is to be in the industry somewhere. Hitman? Are we moving to Denmark, though? Honestly, I was about to say, I'm just some 20-something and I'm up for an adventure, but I'm almost a 30-something. While having a time boost? No. It's like having a permanent credit booster. That's exactly what the time booster is. It is a permanent credit booster. So I have, for 360 days... ...65 credit boosters. Just chillin'. Speed designer on Hitman? Shit. That's pretty cool. I mean, if they have a spot for me, I'll go on an adventure. Right? ECG is a quarter of the way around the world from me. I'm in Texas and they're over in the UK. Right? That would be a real adventure for me. It was very nice when I was over there for the little time I was over there. But at the end of the day, that's still a culture I'm not familiar with, in large part. So it would be a huge adventure. And I would be very fascinated to go on it. Nine positions available and some internships. I've wanted to do internship or try for internships, but pretty much all the internships that I'm aware of are for students, and I haven't been a student for a couple of years now. And even then, I was a student for way longer than I should have been. Not sure I'd go with the brawler, but whatever. We're probably gonna see Kurt again. More than likely, we're gonna see Kurt again. Because we're so high in the MMR brackets, there's not going to be a whole lot of people here for us to fight against, so we're probably going to repeatedly fight against Kurt today. Maybe be on his team once or twice. But it's going to be mostly fighting. Quartermain. Hi, Quartermain. Welcome to the stream. I am just north of 1400 MMR. So I am solidly in bracket three, although I personally would not consider myself super duper good or anything. I've just been playing a long time. I've had the luxury of growing up with this game, so I've gotten to experience a lot. A lot. I am Fractured Space's longest running streamer, and that is official. You can ask them and they will back me up. Oh my god, it's Millennia! How long have I been playing Fractured Space? I have been playing since the technical alpha in October of 2014. I am one of the longest... I'm one of the people that's been around Fractured Space the longest. It actually is official that I am the longest running Fractured Space streamer. Like I just said, it is official. You can ask you can send an email to them and they will tell you it is me. It is I, Zared, who is the person that is I, who is Zared. Oh wait, no, what? We're gonna go to Alpha. Test pilot? Of course I am. I've also been to ECG headquarters. It was a absolutely wonderful way to spend $2,000. A little while ago, only 670 MMR. As long as you're having fun, that's what's important at the end of the day. If you're having fun, kick ass. All right, let's get in there. Leetonitis. Oh, no, super, no, 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 that's bad, and you should feel bad. That is bad, and you should feel bad. Oh. Boop. Oh, he's not killing the buoy. Nice! Alright, there goes his armor. Let's see if we can get a... Ah, there he goes. Boop! Alright. Destroyer's going after the levee. We'll go after the levee, too. Boop! Miskulls! Boop! Hey, super lifter. I'm gonna boop you. Boop! I'm gonna missiles you. I'm gonna chrono blink. Whoop! Boop! 3, 2, 1, boop you to death! Not boop you to death. No, you had armor. Lame. Death boop. Death boop. Death boop. Assisted death boop. Leetonitis. Boop. Miskulls. Oh. Death boop. Ranger, you have my permission to piss off. Post on the Steam servers, usernames, got streams earlier. I post every once in a while. I'm not super active on forums just because, let's be perfectly honest, forums tend to be cesspits. So I'm generally somebody who likes to keep my nose clean. I prefer, I'm a hermit. The vast majority of my interactions with the community are through my stream, or is through my stream here. All right, just because lots of people tend to get really nasty and just trolly, and I don't care to deal with that. I mean, I'm not
I'm not a saint myself by any stretch of the imagination, but I just, you know, I could spend my time posting on the forums and talking about whatever and getting mad at video games, or I could just play and have a good time. Yes, they don't allow links to be whispered because viruses. Oh. Dang it, I missed. Thought for sure I was gonna hit him. Why are we all lemminged? Why are there four of us in here? There don't need to be four of us in here. What are you guys doing? Hey, Hans. Hey, cutie. How you doing? All right, we're gonna take out there. Oh, what? Did I take it out? Take it out? What? Hey, Hans. Oh no! That was highly unfortunate. Gonna boop you, Hans. I told you. Okay. You. Ow. That hurt a lot. Alright, we're gonna throw that out. To at least help our allies, because I'm gonna die. But yeah, I've been around a very long time. I have been streaming Fractured Space since day one. Right? I actually wanted to stream Fractured Space before it hit early access. But they said, hey, you're not forced to. You're not under NDA or anything. But if you would please. Don't talk about this, don't show it yet. Wait for us to hit early access. I was like, okay. So I did.
Carrier has arrived.
Arakanto, thank you very much for the follow. I do in fact appreciate it, as you are directly contributing towards my conquest of this planet and the establishment of the Terran Star Empire. We could all use a little empire. YouTube channel or Steam guides? I have a YouTube channel that I don't do a damn thing with, and Steam guides, not a writer of Steam guides. The vast majority of what I do is this stream right here. Click follow last time. It's all right. We've all done that. Thank you guys for the follows. Who was that that just followed? I gotta thank you by name. After I fight for Gamma. I fight for Gamma! Kuda, thank you very much for the follow. I do in fact appreciate it for all those reasons that I said before. But I just said them, so I'm like not gonna worry about it. I hope you don't mind. Ah, stop it with the beams! Stop it with the beams! Oh, son of a monkey. Damn it, are you kidding me? Alrighty, so next we're gonna try and take out that Pioneer. Infiltrator, what are you doing? Kinda need you to join us. Oh, I'm turned around. I thought I was facing the other way. And I miss Millennia hardcore right there. Ooh, man, I'm doing badly. Jeez! I can't hit a damn thing. What is going on? Zared, we know you're bad, but holy crap, dude. There you go. Are you kidding me? Can I just kill the soup? No. I have some valuable insights for sure. I do. Kind of, maybe. I don't know. Feel free to ask questions here. I love questions.
Love questions. Love questions.
All right. I'm here. I am glad. I will sit here and talk about stuff. I focus my efforts on Twitch because it's what I feel comfortable at. It's what I feel good at. Good at. Right? Like, whenever I make YouTube videos, it feels forced. It doesn't feel like I'm doing my best content. I always feel best live and, you know, making things up as I go and being honest, reacting honestly rather than doing what I do with YouTube, which ends up being, why the balls are you guys hanging out back there? Instead of doing stuff on YouTube, which ends up feeling very scripted, and I don't feel good when I'm scripted. Are you shitting me? Juke, though. What ship is this? This is the Executioner. It is a burst DPS ship with a little bit of range. I am being terrible with my accuracy. And honestly, it's actually pretty frail. I'm just not being focused down because my accuracy is so bad. I couldn't hit the broadside of a barn from the inside of the barn. Jesus Christ, I am so not doing well. I am doing terribly. Got him. Okay. We're doing so badly. Or I should say, I am doing so badly, and me doing so badly is heavily impacting my team. I am not doing well. I am not doing well at all. Alright, so what do we got here? Ranger. There we go. Solid hit. Solid hit. Got him again. Good, good, good. Let's see. Missiles? Yes, sir! Yeah, there we go. I didn't quite get that last shot off. Dang, if I'd have been quicker on my overdrive, I could have switched to my... had that Gauss cannon shot off a little bit quicker. A little bit quicker. Okay. Shit. Normally don't like to use that early. But it was kind of needed. We are actually in a very bad position right here. Ah, just barely missed Millennia right there. Alrighty. Who is my team shooting at? Alright, there we go. That's a dead super lifter. That's one down. Alright. Now Millennia is really close. He's feeling some hurt. There we go, two shots into him. See, can we get a third? Yes, we can. That finishes him off. All right, we're gonna do a chrono blink. Oh, totally missed that pioneer right there. Oh, boop, there we go. Come on, I'm gonna boop you to death, dude. I'm gonna boop the shit out of you. Come on, get booped, nerd. Get booped, nerd. Oh, be dead. Oh! Booped! Oh! Let's boop the shit out of this Leviathan. Come on, Levy! Boop! Yes! Gamma 2 acquired! Maximum boopage! Engage! Boop! Yeah! Get booped. Ah, I missed. I helped, but I missed. All right, if they're gonna keep teleporting in here, we can keep fighting them. All right, Millennia, come on. There you go. Jump again. There you go. All right. Now I'm gonna put my slow out. Yes! Look at that! So good. Okay. I'm gonna jump to beta. Because it looks like our infiltrators got the right idea. And before... Hitomi! Welcome to the stream. What ship do you guys recommend after Sentinel for 300k? Yeah, Reaper. Reaper's just so good. Reaper's the best. It's my favorite ship in the game. I can't not recommend it. Hey, Super Lifter! I'm gonna come get you! Alright, we're gonna throw that out there. Get booped again. We're gonna head back. Oh, I should have gone forward. I didn't even notice. I didn't even notice that he captured the point. Alright, we gotta get in there. Hey, Super Lifter. Hey, buddy. It's not gonna hit. Got him. Whoop! Oh! No! Hans! No, 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 no! No, 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 get out of here, nerd! Get out of here, nerd! Yeah! That was... Oh my. This was quite close, yes. I was sweating a bit right there. Don't you know? Yes. Quite. Alright, I'm going to go to Alpha. Then they are going to capture the base. And then I'm going to jump into the enemy base. Quite. It will be lovely. Yes. I should have died right there. So you mean I should be on that Discovery TV show? I shouldn't be alive? That thing? Woo! 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 Hey, Levy. No, 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 no. We win! Hooray!
That's true, Sugar Rush was doing damage. Doing damage, doing work with them heals.
Boom!
12, 2, 1, and 6. That's not too bad. It's not great. That's not too bad. Oh, hey. Bronze pod. Cool. We'll open that in a minute.
Oh, we got the Executioner! Skilled! Hooray! 17 MMR. Hooray! I have been promoted to... Toonzilla Killer! Hey!
I don't even know! Toonzilla is actually the Chief Production Officer, I think is his title. What's the next one? Gladiator Bader? Wow! I like that, Gladiator Bader. Okay, that went pretty good. MVP to the Super Lifter.
Millennia is 1900, damn! Stop being so good, Millennia, Jesus Christ.
1450. Need a list with all the high rank names. That'd be nice. But yeah. Oh!
So, Vitomi, are you still here? Are you still here? Because I know you were asking about ships earlier. Since we're in between games, we can talk about ships some. I can show stuff off. Getting snow earlier than North Snow in Europe came. Alrighty. What would you like to know about ships? What would you like to know about ships so that I can show you stuff? Because I know you mentioned the Sentinel earlier. What exactly do you like about the Sentinel? I'm going to be perfectly honest. It's not my favorite ship. It makes me very angry. Teach him about the old Hunter meta. Oh, God. Loadout on the Reaper? The only thing I change is I use the Scourge Beam instead of the standard Scythe Beam. But, I mean, I personally don't like the Sentinel just because it's annoying. It's got a smart gun. It's an attack ship. And a lot of the ships that I... Or my favorite ship is easily countered by a ship that just kind of gets up above it and goes, haha, you can't hit me, meh. Mid-range that I don't have to aim. Oh, boy. Well, no, not really this. Because really, the only attack-centric ship that has a tracking weapon is going to be the Sentinel here. Everything else is going to require you to aim. I mean, the Raven right here, it is an attack ship that has a homing weapon, but the purpose of the main weapon itself is not to do damage. The Raven is a ship that works off of energy. So, mainly what your main weapon is set up to do is it does a little bit of damage, but it's feeding you energy over your cap. You'll notice I've got like twice the energy of what you would normally have. And that sets you up for the overcharge beam, which you have to aim, but I mean, I just did 4,500 damage on an unarmored section of a Colossus. That's nothing to shake a stick at. That is nothing to shake a stick at. But your whole purpose as the Raven is to piss people off. It is so good because your beam does respectable damage. Your main weapon drains energy and gives you energy. Here. Your missiles drain energy from the target. Here, we can watch that little white bar. I don't know how easy it is for you guys to see, but that effect, that's supposed to negatively affect the drain rate, or the recharge rate. Maybe, oh, it looks like they removed that. Okay. But your one right here, this ability, it is an AoE energy drain for all enemies. It also gives energy to all your allies in range, and it silences, so you can stop people from using non-attack abilities, but you also turn off point defense. So the ideal, quote-unquote, way to use the absorb charge is to go ahead and fire your missiles, and then right as they start to get going, have that go off, and that makes sure that their point defense is down. And then, of course, you beam the shit at them. I mean, personally, I would say if you want something, are there weak points on ships? If yes, how do we find them? Not a... I hesitate to call them weak points, but there are points on ships that just have less armor. Let me kill this bot right here, and I will show you a prime example. I'll bring up my favorite ship. Because it does good damage. But, destroyer. Oh, it's all cool. Brawler. There we go. Let's bring up the Brawler. This ship is an absolute beast at close range DPS. It's also pretty tanky. If I shoot it from the side right here. Ba 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 ba. See, it took me a third of its health. A third of its health to break the armor on the side of it. The Brawler has insane armor on its sides. However, the front has really crappy armor. So let's see. See? That was like so much faster to break the armor on the front of it than it was on the side. No excuse, hello and welcome to the stream. So much faster. So ships do have different armor values on different areas. Generally, they're gonna be pretty even. I mean, the Brawler is a little bit of a special snowflake in that regard because it's got insane armor on its sides and pretty weak armor on its front. But most other ships are generally going to be pretty even in the front and have weaker rear armor. Front, top, and bottom have a third of the armor of the sides on the Brawler? Yeah. Generally, things are going to be a little bit more even than that, but the Brawler stands out and is a nice example of a dramatic difference.
Carrier has arrived.
Thank you very much for the follow, Vidomi. I do, in fact, appreciate it, as you are directly contributing towards my conquest of this planet and the establishment of the Terran Star Empire. But yeah. So, you said you really liked the Sentinel. What appeals to you about the Sentinel specifically? I mean, I know you said medium-range DPS, but that describes a whole lot of the ships. Do you like having the CC from the slow missiles? Do you like just having a whole lot of weaponry? Do you like the little bit of utility that the propulsion field buoy provides? Or is it just kind of a neat thing? Right, I know I'm asking a lot of questions. I just want to recommend you a ship that you'll actually like. Of course, you can try out all of the ships before you buy them in the firing range like I am here, but you know, I want to try and steer you in the right direction. Woohoo! Yeah. Alright, what can we screw around with? Don't really know. Just like to play with it. Maybe the lots of weapons? Okay. Okay. I can get behind. I don't know, I just kinda like it. I can totally get behind that as a reason. Right? Okay. Then, because I'm me and everybody expects me to do this, and let's be real, I'm gonna do it anyway. I do really recommend the Reaper right here. So the Reaper is a mid-range attack ship. If you continue to watch me, what you're going to see is me using the Reaper incorrectly. But your main weapon has a range of 15 kilometers, and your missiles have a range of 14 kilometers in a straight line. Probably the coolest thing to me about the Reaper, hello Eric, welcome to the stream, is the scythe beam. Now, I'm using a variant of the scythe beam, so normally it only sweeps once, this one sweeps twice, but normally you'd have to, you know, sit there and bam, bam, pew, 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 and shoot through somebody's armor in order to, you know, destroy it and then do more damage. Or you could break their armor with a Scourge Beam / Scythe Beam. Oh look, his armor's broke. Now I do a lot more damage. Pew 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 pew. But the Reaper is a phenomenal ship. It also comes with a nice shroud ability, which comes in three different flavors. This is my preferred flavor, the vanilla shroud, which makes you completely invulnerable from the sides as long as they actually hit the shroud. You do stick out a little bit in the front and back so they can still pop you if they're good with their aiming. You're also open from the top and the bottom. It also has a version that covers the top and the bottom and not the sides. It also comes with a version that covers the top, the bottom, and the sides, leaving the rear and the front open, but it doesn't last for nearly as long as the other two variants. I like the Scourge Beam right here, because unlike the normal Scythe Beam, it sweeps back and forth instead of just once. What other ships are pretty good and not horribly difficult to play? I would say Omni is garbage. It's not... I hesitate to call it garbage, but I haven't come up with a good reason to use it. I would also recommend the Displacer. By the way, for the Reaper and this ship right here, I have super special, mega awesome, expensive skins. So they look a little bit better than they normally would. The Displacer is another pretty good ship. It is not a sniper. I consider it a sharpshooter. It's got like an 18k range on its main weapon. It also can displace people, so I can shoot my displace marker out. If it connects with the target, I'll get this lovely white beam, and I can hit mouse 2 and push him away. See, there you go. I just pushed him back to 16 kilometers. He can't do a damn thing, and I can just peck away at him. It also comes with a repulse ability, which I need to get close to him in order to be able to use. Watchman or Guardian? I prefer the Guardian. It's more fun to play. Enforcer? I'll show the Enforcer after this. It also comes with repulse, which... well, sometimes people get close to you and you don't like that, so you use your personal bubble and they get away. Very, very useful in Gamma for knocking people out of the Gamma bubble. Displacer Harpoon? Yeah. Displacer Harpoon and the Brawler Harpoon can be used on allies to push in the case of the Displacer, or pull in the case of the Brawler. And then it was recommended that I show off the Enforcer, which is a lovely little ship. It only has one weapon, and that is Escalate. Now, the thing about Escalate is it fires a whole bunch of rounds in succession, and for each one that hits, the damage of the next one is going to be increased. And the more that hits, the more the next one's gonna do, and it's gonna cause the next one to do more, and the next one to do more, and the next one to do more. So if I just sweep like that, I did like 80 damage, which is nothing. But if I hit with everything, I broke his armor and did 4,300. Not too bad. You do have to wait in between volleys, which can be kind of, you know, boring, depending on how you are. You have a blink to target ability, which can be used to blink to allies or enemies. A cap mod buoy, which comes in three flavors. I'm using the vanilla flavor right here. Anybody in this sphere of influence that is on your team will have their capture power increased. Any enemy in here will have their capture power decreased. There's also two other flavors that trade one power for the other. So there's one that makes your team cap really well, but doesn't really prevent the enemy capping. Or prevents the enemy from capping, but doesn't really help your team out. You also have Concussed Shot, which the vanilla version applies a slow and a 2-second silence. So people can't use like boosts or blinks or stuff like that. You can even interrupt blinks if you time it really well. And it of course also comes in two flavors that, you know, you can have a better slow at the expense of the silence, or you can have a better silence at the expense of the slow. Once had a match with four deaths being a ghost. The ghost is a very tough ship to play. The ghost is a very tough ship to play. There's really no two ways about it. This is a difficult ship. I really wouldn't recommend it to newbies, but I mean, you know what? You do you. If you have fun, go for it. 4-4 deaths was by the ghost. Stealth ships tend to be a problem for a lot of people. They even cause problems for people that are plenty experienced dealing with them. Alright. Actually, let's surrender and see what happens. Nothing. Okay. Playing Watchmen? Oh, yeah, that would be why. Watchmen, whenever you're playing a Watchmen and there's a ghost on the enemy team, you have a target just right on your forehead. There's no two ways about it. Alright, let's get back in it. Actually, to you newer players, is there a ship you guys would like to see played? Because I don't mind taking some time out and playing a couple of solo versus bot games to show you guys ships that you're interested in. I mean, I'm not super competent with all of the ships, but I'm decent enough that I should be able to do it, you know, to play versus bots and wean. TP Leviathan? Son of a bitch! God damn it, Sailor Boy. You rat bastard. I already played the Leviathan today. Can you play the Guardian? Sure thing. Sure thing. We're gonna do Guardian, Executioner, Ranger. How do you Ranger? Oh my, we're gonna play bot games all day today. Alrighty. Your troll pick still counts, Sailor Boy. But yeah, we're gonna be spending time showing off ships. Okay, since the Guardian was requested first, I will play the Guardian first. So the Guardian is my preferred. What? Hey, that's not right. I didn't click that.
Carrier has arrived.
Eric, thank you very much for the follow. I do, in fact, appreciate it, as you are directly contributing towards my conquest of this planet and the establishment of the Terran Star Empire. Well, that's lame. Let's see if that gives me a leave. I'm legitimately curious. Didn't pick the Guardian, pick the Venture? Well, I fail. So as you can see, I don't play snipers very often because my accuracy is shit. Okay, good. Okay, here's the thing though. It does count as a leave. It does count as a leave if you quit a solo versus AI game. That's not good. Never get the phase or optic now. Oh no. Alrighty. Guardian. Confirm. But the Guardian to me is the most dynamic of the sniper ships because of its blink buoy ability. Normally, with the other two snipers currently in the game, namely the Watchman and the Overseer, you don't really have a whole lot to do when people get on top of you. You don't, there's not a whole lot you can really do. But with the Guardian, you can set up a blink buoy and go off and do your own thing and blah, 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 and shoot people. And then, oh no! Oh wait, it killed my buoy. Replace that bot with it. It's supposed to. Anyway. So, first thing we're gonna do when we get in is I'm gonna set up my blink buoy right there. So as soon as I get in trouble, I'm gonna blink, and I will blink right back to the back right there. Okay, so the Guardian's main weapon works on a charge system and has a 30k range. So I hold the mouse one button down, wait for the charge to hit full, and then I shoot people in the spaceship. What the F? You all saw that? I was aimed correctly. There we go. But as you can see, because I've got that blink buoy way back there that I can bug out to when I need to. All I'm gonna do is go forward. I can go forward and cap, and if I get into trouble, I have an escape. Alrighty. You can hold on to your charge for a little while. After a while, it'll start giving you a little warning saying, hey, you're about to overheat, hey. And then you gotta fire or you gotta reset the shot. But once you get used to it, you'll just be able to set up for and let go whenever you're whenever your shot's ready. So I'm gonna jump back. I was gonna say I'm gonna switch lanes. What do we got over there? Reaper and Raven. Oh, they ought to be fine. We're gonna go back to Alpha. Stick with the Watchmen. Well, I still haven't shown you everything. I've also got this lovely little right mouse button ability called Nuke Rocket. What does the Nuke Rocket do, you might ask? And I would reply, well, it shoves motherfuckers out of cover. So let's say where you want to shoot that Pioneer, but he's behind cover. So what we can do is I can fire my Nuke Rocket, and it'll go until it gets in range, and then it'll explode, and it'll move him. Without somebody actually, like, hiding, it's kind of hard to show what it does. But just like you sometimes get shoved by death explosions, you basically have that as a weapon on cooldown. You know what? I want to go get level 3. So I'm going to blink to Bowie. Hey, look at that. We're way back here. Watchmen can't do that. Because the Watchmen's a bitch. Yeah, you'll lose out on a little bit of DPS with the Guardian versus the Watchmen. But it's more than made up for in the fact that you can do more than sit there and get murdered. Alright, that's enough of this. I'm just gonna rack up a shit ton of leaves today. Alright, what was that next one that was requested? Ranger. Okay, Executioner and then Ranger. Okay. Can it blink to another lane? No, it cannot. And rockets and the ability to mark target. Mark target is very useful in the right team comp. Executioner. Alrighty. So Executioner is all about that burst damage. All about that burst damage. Bing. Bam. 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 Your main weapon is a really slowly charging set of Gauss cannons that will fire 2 projectiles and has a maximum range of 12 kilometers. It has a little charging doohickey right there in the center of the screen, makes a visual noise. It has an audio cue for whenever it's done. And then it charges up and blah blah blah. Right? Alrighty. First ability on number one is Overdrive. What does Overdrive do? It drinks your energy much like a milkshake. It also makes you move faster. And it makes you fire faster. As you can see, I have a pretty fast fire rate right now. Now, you will do less damage when you're using Overdrive, but you will fire faster. So what you can do is you can get somebody low, dip into Overdrive for a second to get a few shots off, and then you'll be good! Oh boy. Alright. Then right there, I just dropped the Stasis Field Buoy. What does the Stasis Field Buoy do? All enemies inside that radius will have a status effect called Stasis applied to them, which is a, I believe, 20% slow per stack, and it stacks all the way up to 5. So he's got 3 on him right there, 4. He's moving real slow. You've got a set of missiles that fire pretty fast, don't do a whole lot of damage. But those are 3 of your bigger, or 3 of your more highly used abilities. You'll also notice there's this trail of arrows following me, and there's this ghost executioner following me. Your right mouse button is chrono blink, which will take you back to where that ghost is. It's a, what, 35 second timer? Yeah, it takes you back to the position you were so many seconds in the past. I don't remember how many seconds, but you are given a visual indicator. Every time you use it, the ghost is reset, but it's a very, very useful escape tool. I mean, you can use Overdrive to cruise way the hell far up lane, and then, oh man, there's like 3 guys there. I don't want to fight them. Chrono blink back, and you're fine. Pretty much DPS or DPM. This is a DPM style ship. This is a DPM style ship. Because, I mean, you're not... All of your damage is burst. Pretty much. I mean, you've got your rail cannons and your missiles, and that's it. That is it for damage. If you get a really solid hit on a ship that has no armor, you can do a crap ton of damage. But you will also be doing a whole lot of breaking armor. It's actually very similar to the Enforcer. In how it behaves, like, damage-wise, except instead of you've got a short ramp-up time, it's just BAM! All at once. So, they're very similar ships that play pretty differently. Hey, Attila, welcome to the stream. But yeah, it's a really solid ship if you get good at it. In the lower MMR brackets, people are going to complain about how just bloody overpowered you are. Oh my god, I can't do it with the Executioner, it does too much damage. There are people in the higher brackets that complain about the Executioner, and it used to be really out of control. Really out of control. Now it's only, you know, painful to deal with and not OP as balls. Okay, the Ranger. Ranger's a good ship. However, be under no illusion that you are going to be some DPS monster when playing the Ranger. Because you aren't. It doesn't let me pick my loadout. So I've got the Tri-Cannon, which is not normally something you come with. But yeah. With the Ranger, as with all small ships, your job is to be an annoying piece of shit. That's what you do. You are annoying as fuck. It's also what I would classify as a sharpshooter. It's not really a sniper, but you've got enough range to where you can screw with people and they can't mess with you. Right here, I'm using the Tri-Cannon. Normally, you have a single-shot cannon, but this is a loadout option. Your number one ability is Detect, Slow, and Pulse. It's an AoE button. You hit it. Everything within range will be detected and slowed. Hey, Rob, how you doing? Make a tea and play a little bit? Awesome! Awesome! I hope you enjoy your playtime. If you have questions, please feel free to continue hanging out in here and ask questions. We love questions. We love newbies. All right, I want to make sure you have a good time. Let's see. Also, you've got some missiles that, you know, aren't horribly exciting. You've got stealth mines, which you throw out a bunch of mines and they're stealthed. They're very, very annoying. They're very good for booby trapping mining bases, or for using whenever people on a location people are going to jump in on. You also have shutdown and repair. So I can, gotta hold it down. So I use shutdown and repair, and right now, I'm going to get healed up to full. While this is happening, you will take extra damage and you can't move. There is a version of it that you can get where you can still move, but you're still going to be taking extra damage. But generally, what you're going to be doing is running around, dropping stealth mines on people, being really damned annoying. But you are a small ship. Your job is not to do damage. It is to piss people off. So right now, what I really should be doing is running away. Oh, I am completely out of energy because of that Raven. All right, so we need to... Oh, boy, get over here, and we're going to jump out. So he can't do anything to us. Yeehaw. And see, now I can shut down and repair if I wanted, but I don't. You know, I really should just go in there and repair. But yeah, you can't do a dang thing while you're repairing. This allows you to be annoying and operate all on your lonesome and be okay, provided you have a few seconds to hide. But, you know, you need to be sneaking behind people and taking pot shots. You need to be dropping stealth mines on mining bases. You need to be going for caps. Your job isn't to do what I'm about to do right here, which is get stuck in. So, like, I'm gonna drop all these stealth mines right here. And myrtleize that guy. Then we're gonna get an upgrade. We're gonna murder that guy. But then what I need to be doing now is I need to go up to the top of the map, or to one of the sides, kind of a little bit out of way of people, and be annoying. So I'm gonna go way up here. Do we got anybody else in the lane right now? I don't see anybody. There we go, Sentinel. Come here, Sentinel. We're gonna take pot shots at you. Oh, even better. There's a Reaper. See, look at this. Look at this. He can't do a damn thing about us right now. He can shoot missiles at us, but I mean, I could just point defense and do those in. So even though we're not doing a whole lot of DPS, we can just sit here all day. Piss off this Reaper pilot. I know whenever I'm fighting a Ranger that's doing this to me, I want to wring his neck. doing this to a Reaper pilot does not make them happy. It will not win you any friends. There will be no, you know, friendly pizza party afterwards. There will only be salt. Anyway. Let's get out of here and actually play a game. So when do we get a high-speed Initial D ship that plays Gallo Sangoon whenever you do sick high sonic base caps? But we've already got the equalizer. Alright. Let's play. Quiet Earth? I know they're saying Quiet Earth here, but what I hear is Wyatt Earp. There we go. We got us the game, and because Sailor Boy decided to be cheeky little shit, we get to play the Leviathan. I hate you, Sailor Boy, so much. So much right now. The equalizer is affected by magic space air drag. If you want Newtonian physics, go someplace else. Alright, Leviathan. Boop! Confirmed. Let's play some Leviathan. I'm sorry. Let's get murdered while playing the Leviathan. Troll pick equalizer. Raiden, you son of a monkey! These are my viewers, ladies and gentlemen. These are the people that like to. that like to watch my show. Mm. Yes. Mm. Yes. Quite. Yes. Okay. So, I'm gonna alter my loadout slightly. I'm gonna use the Flamer, Executioner, Reaper, Superlifter, Colossus, Hunter. Okay. Yeah, that's what I wanna use. That's what I wanna use. Slide the lid out right? Yes.
Mmm. We will resist and fight for them.
I don't know what the fuck that was.
Okay, so, since we've been actually, like, doing stuff for a little while now, how has the stream looked? Has the quality been pretty high? Even during action sequences? 8-Bit Moose, Ichiban, Dark Forces, MC, Devil Kitty, and Mikey Jam. Okay, Dark Forces, I know he's pretty good.
I don't know anybody else. Looks slightly better.
Hmm. Hmm.
Human, I can't see above 1600 kbps.
Wow. God damn it, Sailor. With the memes.
I like that. That needs to be a thing. That needs to be a thing. I like this song. I'm gonna turn this up.
I also happen to really like Tyr. Tyr is pretty freaking cool, man.
Under pressure.
Superlifter, Colossus, Executioner. Healers and Executioners, baby. Oh boy. Oh boy, Mr. Healer. Alrighty. I would like to go forward and not backward whenever I hit forward. That would be super swell. Okay. But I can rock you. Okay. Come on, we can kill this guy. I can out DPS his heals. There we go, much better. He's got the near beam. Oh, bless his little heart. Bless his little heart, the protector's got the near beam. I was about to say, hang back at 20k, man. No. Okay, newbies. I'm a level with you here. I love you guys. But if you're gonna play the protector, don't use anything other than the standard heal beam. At all.
It is so not worth it. This is not the pulse beam. Well, the pulse beam still has range. He's got to be within 7,500 meters in order to get anybody. He's just going to get myrtillated this whole game. Heals. Pretty cool. I know I'm making fun, but fight me. Oh, he's boosting away. Okay. Hey, Super Lifter. How you doing, buddy? We're gonna go after this Super Lifter now. Yeah, get yourself a heal, buddy. How come you're not using fighters? Honestly, I'm just terrible at micro. Like, not even kidding. I'm pretty not good at this game. The only reason my MMR is so high is because you guys just haven't been playing as long as I have. You guys will end up getting better than me, I promise. I am stupendously not good. Alright, we're gonna head back. But yeah. Fighters don't do a whole lot of damage. Pretty much their only use, yeah, is to go after other fighters or drones. They don't do no damage, but the damage they do isn't fantabulous by any stretch of the imagination. So I'm gonna go ahead and go really early, because I have a feeling that the enemy team is gonna be there soon. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and drop a jump point. So hopefully my team decides to join me. Alright, oh no, Protector Buddy! You went way over there! No, Protector Buddy! Oh, hey, Super Lifter, come here. Come here. We're just gonna wail on you a bit. I hope that's okay. If it's not, too bad. Blah! Alright, there we go. Much better. Alright, now let's go after that Executioner. I'm surprised that our Protector's still alive. Did he die and come back? We got it! Congratulations, everybody! It's a Gamma One. No! Four. Hooray! I like how it's the Leviathan's jump beacon and not our jump beacon. There we go. Ah, alrighty. Not too bad, not too bad. Man, our poor protector. He's got two support points. Aww. Little buddy, he tries his hardest. Oh, that reminds me of something. Ah, hold on. I'll bring it up here in a second. Oh, Hunter, you brave? You brave? Get off my point. I'm gonna let them go ahead and... Oh! Caught while jumping by the Black Widow. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna head to Beta. Yeah. Oh man, four of them. All right, kill the Reaper, guys. All right, we're actually gonna set the fighters out on him. You'll notice this Reaper is just sitting here being a turret. New fish, this is exactly what you do not want to do. Being a turret is not a good idea. If you're sitting still and you're not hiding or a sniper, man, we just got smushed. Meanwhile, in Alpha. And they're just gonna go right on in. No fucks given. Hey, you guys ain't using this base, are you? Oh my. Oh my. Ooh, yes.
Alright, we're gonna go right for beta. Oh, get out of there, executioner! Oh, boy. Oh, boy. This is not good. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. I need you in Gamma with me. I need you in Gamma with me. We're all friends here. I need you in Gamma with me. I realize this probably not going to happen, but I would like for you to be in Gamma. I would appreciate your presence in Gamma. I would appreciate it. Please come to Gamma. There we go. Yay! People coming to Gamma. Oh, hey, Hunter. Oh, you came to the wrong neighborhood, pal. Alrighty. Oh, come on. Alright, there you go. He jumped. Alright, so who did they kill? Come on. Who is anybody shooting at? Oh, no. That is so not good. Okay. Alright, I know he used his shroud. That's the only reason I'm shooting at him. We need to kill guys. And this guy, I can kill him. There we go. Okay. Alrighty, come on! No! No! Ah! Do anything alone is the most way to get your shit obliterated. This is true. You should donate your voice a bit to create a new commander. You could be green and be... You know what? If the guys at ECG would have me be a crew member, I'd do it in a hot second. No lie. I would get that. I would do that so quick. You guys have no idea. I could put it on my resume. Hey, I'm in a video game. Yeah, hold on. Uh-oh. Shit, I forgot I was spawning. Just gonna show you guys something. Remixed Undertale? Yes, it is! Oh no. That was bad. Ah, shit. Right as he jumped away. That's probably game. That is probably game. That is probably game. Alright. This really isn't who we need to be focusing on, but if we've got the DPS to take them out. Oh wait, what am I saying? Of course we do. They've only got a super lifter. Flee in terror! Yeah, I know. Oh, this is so bad. We lost this horribly right here. We lost this so bad.
But yeah, I have Pandora playing in the background. My choice of music is rather wide. Let me see. But yeah, I don't know if any of you will know what this is, or what this is from. But this is what our protector reminds me of. I'm
my cold dead heart. I can't take it. All right, we're gonna go here and we're gonna help out the executioner. This fucking sucks. Because there is nothing I can do about this. Oh my gosh! My little protector cute.
Wow.
Photoshop that now. You have a project, Sailor Boy. Go do it. Go do it. Ray Lamar, hello and welcome to the stream. How you doing? Oh, if we actually kill them before Gamma, oh boy. Oh man. Seven, six, five, four, nope. Three, two, one. None of that. Fuck out of here, executioner. Good. Okay, so he jumped way back there. Why am I not moving? There we go. Yes! Eat that, you blinky son of a bitch! Now it's your turn, Hunter. We can do this. Maybe I can lure them. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Get in the bubble. Get in the bubble. Yes! How good is this? We're gonna pull this off. Yes!
Hooray! We did it!
I mean, I'm really not sure how that happened, but okay. Honestly, what I'm gonna throw it down to? I'm gonna throw it down to that Black Widow being there and focus firing with me on that Executioner at the start right there. That's what it is. He helped me focus fire right there. That Executioner died. Everybody else melted. It worked out well. Okay. 1466. We're going up. We're going up, ladies and gentlemen. Alright. So that's the Leviathan game out of the way. Now we have an Equalizer game to play. Oh boy. Want a Black Widow? You would like the ship, or you would like to see me play the ship? Just so we're clear. Who has just begun?
Death will make you Ultraman.
Like to have one myself? It's a good ship. It's a very good ship. Especially when you get creative with them missile loadouts. Because, I mean, armor-breaking missiles, plasma missiles, missiles that cause weapons to take longer to reload, missiles that drain energy, that concuss people, and that slow. The utility that the Black Widow brings is amazeballs. Honestly, this is a really cool ship. It's a super cool ship. I really do like it. I like it a lot. But, I'm not good with it. I don't know. Black Edition Black Widow. God, I'm stupid. Why does anybody watch me? Did you like the ship when it first came out? I thought it was okay. I don't remember liking it particularly.
but it also had flak then, which I thought was pretty cool, because it was the only other ship with flak, and I dug it, but then it lost its flak, and I was sad, and then it got tracking rockets, and then I was very angry, and then it lost tracking rockets, and everything was good, yeah. Oh, hey, I've topped 64,000 views. That's pretty good. Not too bad. Not too bad. Ugh. All right. Equalizer. What loadout options does this thing have? Okay, so the standard smart gun, which has a leech and does damage. We could do a little bit less damage but have more leech, or we could do a little bit more damage and have less leech. I'm actually kind of partial to having more leech and doing a little bit less damage, because it's only 3. It's only a 3% difference, but it's a 5.5% difference more for how much you're actually healing yourself. Hey, Dark.
Been so bad that game? I don't know. You were causing me issues. I knew you were somebody to look out for. I was just like, oh god. Oh man.
But honestly, to be perfectly frank, dude, what I think that came down to was me lucking out with Gamma at the very end. And I was trying to right click on Gamma right as Yell's Executioner popped up, and so I clicked target Executioner, and then my Black Widow went after the Executioner, and so we were able to get the Executioner off our backs, which was huge. And so yeah, lucky us. It was simply luck. I really don't think we had any business winning that. Well, he was trying. What you missed though was that our protector had the near beam. Equalizer. Oh boy! This is gonna be so much fun! Yeah! This is gonna be so much fun! Yeah! Really interested to see what the quality of this is of the VOD ends up looking like for this, since we're working with 2,000 bit rate instead of 1,300. If it's not a huge difference, I'm gonna be so sad. I'm gonna be so sad if it's not a huge difference. Would've been better, probably. Cause I'm terrible with a levy. Oh, 2 hunters. And a disruptor? Oh, God. I bet better not be Kurt and 2 hunters. That better not be Kurt and 2 hunters grouped together. I'm gonna cry. I'm going to cry and curse my fate if that's what we're fighting against. I will cry. Back. The Reaper is a beast, just need to learn to play with it. I'm glad you like it. It is my favorite ship for a reason. It is
the best.
The Kuno for more emo. I don't know, I thought my protector can't be this cute was pretty good.
fox?
What? That can't be. That can't be Fox. Is that Fox? Is that Fox? Is that really Fox? Is that really Fox? Hold on. Not. And asked before? Okay. Damn it. Here I was thinking that might be... There was a guy that used to be a part of the community whom I worked with on my podcast when I did my stuff, or when I actually did my podcast, and one of the guys was Fox, and he was a pretty cool guy. He was a pretty cool guy. But he got himself an absolutely amazeballs job, and so went and did that instead of playing Fractured Space, which I can't blame him. I can't blame him at all. I should check in with him and see if his project has come to fruition yet. Oh, he came with me. Holy shit. That is not what we needed to have happen. That is not what we needed to have happen right there. Holy crap. Okay. Who's that? That's the disruptor? Okay, let's murder that disruptor. Not gonna kill him, but that was a fair amount of damage. Hey, I got him with the dot. How about that? I guess there was another tick right as he was jumping. This went from to okay. Pretty quick. This persecutor's just hanging out with me, and that's pretty cool. Alright, Percy. We're going in, boys!
Oh no! Alrighty. Yeah, one of the reasons I was so not thrilled about seeing those two hunters is because hunters are not exactly a hard counter, but they're very good for countering disruptors. Or for executioners, excuse me. Mr. Gladiator, how you doing? It is the Ginger Gladiator, everyone. Lead artist at ECG and all around pretty cool dude. He's recently become one of those dad things. So that means he now has license to make, you know, very, very horrible jokes and have people go, "Oh man." All right, I want utility. Hunter's executioner. Yeah, I dropped myself on my head as a child, so I always mix up names. But yeah, no, hunters are really good counters for equalizers because they're just as mobile and they do more damage. You guys gonna leave me the fuck alone here? I guess you are. Okay. Oh, forgot my purge. See, look at him. He's able to, by the time he needs to jump on me again. He can just. Really? Are you guys serious? They just left me alone, okay. Oh, shit. And that is why, whenever you jump in combat, you use a standard jump and you don't jump to home. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. Oh, we got it! Nice! Ooh. Kinda right, yeah. Well, multiple hunters are pretty good for against everything. Because, I mean, nobody wants to deal with multiple hunters. I mean, if you had multiple persecutors, it wouldn't be too bad. But, I mean... That's kind of the whole point of the, persecutor is to murder the shit out of the hunter, and ships like it. That right there I used that because I knew that they were going to end up following me. Ugh. Because if I had gone to Alpha or Beta right there with that escape jump, excuse me. They could have followed me easily and murdered the crap out of me. So how is... Are you getting enough sleep, Mr. Gladiator? Have you... Do you miss work yet? The relative peace and quiet and organization... Right at A2. Yep, they all jumped to A2 and didn't find me. Oh, hey, look, it's that gladiator. Uh-oh. Okay. Oh, the mobility suppression comes out. Get murdered, Hunter. Alrighty. No, I still do damage. Alrighty. So we're gonna go ahead and capture this point. We're gonna upgrade utility again, because I want to be able to boost gate even faster. Now I know. Hey, buddy! There's an enemy ship right there. Whoa! Okay. You, Disruptor. Oh, wait. I can just purge it. I can purge your disarm. Ha ha ha. Alright, everybody's going after that gladiator, so I guess I will too. Hey, Roscoe. Stop it, would you? Okay, I need these guys to keep chasing me as long as possible, because the whole time that they're chasing me, they're not chasing my allies, which is exactly what I need to have happen. All right, Roscoe, what I could... Yeah, there you go. Come on. Don't hit me. Yes! Damn it. I got in there for a little bit, though. But see, that's... what I needed to be doing. Although they wiped us. Okay. Okie dokie. We're gonna go to Alpha so I can harass Roscoe there. Oh, he's 4-0-0-7. Wow. He's doing pretty good. Alrighty. So what I want...
Damn it. Okay, so they're jumping. That is super not what I need to have happen. Because this is Gamma 3. Okay. It's not really what I want to do. But I'm going to jump in and I'm going to assist with combat. Alright, so one of them is down. Good. Okay, so Roscoe's dead. Roscoe's dead. I'm going to go after Ichiban here. Yeah, this dude has made some life mistakes. That's it. That's it. That's it. We've got this. We've got it. We've got it. Fox is dead. All right. We're good. We got it. Okay, that's Gamma 2. I thought it was Gamma 3. What? Okay, still, I need to get out of here. Because I gotta go capture shit. I'm gonna go capture Alpha 2. See, I'm not used to being level 8 at Gamma 2. Holy crap, we're 2 levels up. Okay, how long until they are up? I'm gonna be just barely able to capture this. So my allies are depending on me right now. I have to cap this. I have to cap this. Right now. Right this second. Alrighty, Hunter. Alrighty, there we go, we're good. Don't care. Cause I'm gonna cap your shit, boys. Yes siree, Bob. I'm in your base capping your dudes. 70%. 80%. Oh! Alright, I need to survive for a few more seconds. Oh, I hit that earlier than I intended. Shit. Okay, it's fine. Fine. So what needs to happen right now is we need to capture this. Okay, so I really hope I'm going to get the time to heal up right now. Oh wow, they actually killed him. Alright, let's go in. It's reminding me of Dreadnought. Well, Animus, Fractured Space is a lot like Dreadnought, if Dreadnought were good. Yes, shots fired. Shots very much fired. 92%! Alright, I need to go help that enforcer. He's trying to kill that healer. No. You're not gonna disarm my guy. You will kill him though. Oh! 95%! Stop it. let's get out of here. Was good, but not for a while now. It, to me, Dreadnought was never compelling as a game. Graphically, it's very impressive. But that's it. That's it. I mean, that's really all it's got going for it. I'm gonna wait until the very last second. There we go. Alright, boys, let's cap 5%! Shit! No! They're not supposed to be. Good. He's leaving. Good. Yes! Seven. 8! Nine! Alright, looks like we're stopped at 9. Alright, we're getting out of here. Recommend this game then? Animus, I like this game so much that I blew $2,000 in order to go spend a couple of days with the devs. So, yeah. I would say that if I were pressed into giving an opinion, I would give a positive one about Fractured Space. It's amazeballs. I mean, I'm working on 1,200 hours played. Seriously, from the very first time I played it in technical alpha, just goofing off, I knew that this game was going to be something different. I knew that this game was special from day one. Alright, let's get out of here. I could maybe deal with one of those, but not two. But yeah. I'm in Texas and the devs are in the UK. Do you communicate with your team at all over voice, Discord or similar? Nope. When I very first started off streaming, I had some just random ass people on, and they made rear ends of themselves, and so I don't have anybody else on stream unless I know for sure that they're gonna be cool, but don't think the devs want to add it. VoIP is actually something that is being discussed, or rather, is on the docket from what I've seen. Give me one second to bring up the discussion page. Alrighty. Let's see, discussions, voice chat, here we go.
You will want to see this. With regards to voice chat. But yeah. That went better than expected. That went better than I expected it to. No medal this game.
4-2-8. Ugh.
That's pretty bad. Not super great. Having in-game communication tools for group isn't a bad thing. Well, I know me personally. I don't like talking to random people, and I'm gonna opt out. I mean, if I can't opt out, to be perfectly honest, I would stop streaming Fractured Space until I could, because here's the thing that some people don't know about having other people on your Twitch. You are actually responsible for what they say. So if I had somebody on and they decided to make just spew horrible things from their mouth, and somebody got a bug up their rear, they could report me for it. So the Interceptor has been troll picked, so my next ship is decided. Don't know why this guy lost 26. But my next ship has been decided. So let's get to it. But yeah. Oh my, 28 people. That is not a number we usually see on a weekday. Cider boy, you're not even funny. Not even funny. Anybody care to guess what's in the bronze drop pod? The only thing you have to guess specifically, like number-wise, is the amount of credits. Otherwise, you can just blurt out what you think it's going to be. And if you get it right, 200 Zerg bucks, which is enough for a troll pick. If nobody's interested, I'll just open them. Like it. Oh my. I should probably wash this. Whoop, 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 whoop. Crew member. Anybody at all care to guess? Anybody? No? Alright, no guesses. No guesses, I guess I'll just open them. Plat? No, still don't see any guesses. No? Okay, I'll just open them after this game. I'll just open them. YOLO. Okay. We're playing the Interceptor. Now, Ichiban, are you going to choose to play a healer or not? If you do, cool. If you don't, cool. Makes no difference to me. Because, I mean, I'm an interceptor. I'm just going to try and myrtleize people either way. Oh! Alrighty, Paladin, Hunter, Raider, Executioner, Destroyer versus Colossus, Superlifter, Basilisk, Raven, Interceptor. Okay, based just off of comp, I'm gonna give it to us. But
actual coordination can totally outstrip whatchamahoozits. Loadout, right? Comp. I'm tired, can you tell? I can't even make words with my face hole. I can't even right now. I do not possess the ability to even. I am a teenage white girl. I can't even right now. I cannot even right now. Oh my god. Uh-oh, it's Gamma Tech. I know Gamma Tech's pretty good. Alrighty. Yeah. Okie dokie. Alpha, beta, alpha. We're gonna go beta just to make sure we've got at least an even 2-2. And leave the last guy to go wherever he's gonna go. Okay. Oh. Executioner. Hello, Raider. Yep. All right, baited that out of him. Good, 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 good. But it looks like we're in the 3v2 lane, which is pretty good for us. Not so good for our allies. I wonder why that graphic isn't showing up. Ah, look, he shot me. Ow! Okay. Get out of here. Oh, hey. Hey, Hunter. Hey, buddy. How you doing? Ow. That hurts. Not wearing tight jeans with useless pockets, Uggs. Fluffy light jacket, bleached hair, tons of makeup. What would Zared look like, blonde? Not good. I don't think I would look good as a blonde. I do not think I would look good as a blonde at all. Although, true facts, if people want to donate like $10,000, I'll dye my hair whatever fucking color. I will do it like biohazard orange if you guys want. Provided I can also get away with it at my job. Gee, it'd be really nice if point defense actually worked against those. We're
We're gonna go ahead and jump back. Yes, there we go. Claiming the surrender vote, so it becomes obvious at least two players want to catch you. I don't know. I try not to surrender. I mean, it happens less in higher brackets, so. Gotcha! Alrighty, you! Stop it! Thank you, Mr. Ishijama, for the host! I do, in fact, appreciate it, but I don't have any kind of, like, specific shtick for being hosted. I need to come up with that. I need more shtick. I need more shtick. Ah! Please tell me I killed that guy. Yes, the Raider's dead. That's all I care about. That's all I care about. All I care about. Icarus Booty? I know, right? I know, right? Where's my Icarus Edition Reaper? And Leviathan. Icarus Edition Leviathan. Yeah. Hell yeah. That would be hot. But do red instead of blue? I mean, that's like cliche as balls, but. Actually, I know there's a couple of guys out there. Actually, I'm pretty sure it's you, Raiden, that specifically would like a Leviathan based on the Shivans from Free Space and Free Space 2, which I think, yes, would be pretty fucking amazing. Gotcha! Alright, we're gonna go heal ourselves. All the viewers gone? Well, I thank you for throwing it my way anyway. Thank you for thinking I'm worth putting on your channel. Cause that's to me, with as jealously as I guard my channel, it's a big deal when somebody puts me on theirs. Hey, Ranth. Oh yeah, it was Ranth. You're the one that wants the Shivanathan. And that zebra camo to go with the purple rain skin. Yeah. What's this early stream time? I gotta go into work tomorrow. I got called into work on a Saturday. Ugh, lame. 10 seconds. Shivanathan? Yeah, that was Rancid. God damn it, all of you moderate R's and your close names, it confuses me in my dumb American brain. You cheeky son of a bitch. Just wait until your salary and don't get paid for working Saturday? Oh, yeah. You get paid, not get paid for working. When you're salaried, Gadezon, your income is steady, right? If for some reason you work 2 hours that week, you're going to get the same amount of money. If you work 60 hours a week or 80 hours a week, you're going to get the same amount of money. That's what salary is. Salaries are generally higher than what you would get if you were hourly, of course. But it's not based on how much time you put in. If your salary, generally the expectation is you're going to work until everything is done. You're always on call, that kind of thing. Sounds like a lot of work. Let's never do it. I'd like to be salaried. Shit. Excuse me. I would like to have a job I enjoy enough that I don't mind being salaried. Oh, and that raven just ate that poor, poor guy alive. Sweet. Oh, glorious air conditioner has come on. Man, I'm the only one that doesn't have gamma buff anymore. Because I decided it would be a good idea to fight 2v1. Oh well. Oh well. Sucks to be me. Do I need to go into beta? Nope, I need to go into the enemy base. Is it hot enough to take for air conditioning? Hell yeah, it is. Ah! Just gonna chill. Hey, Gamma Tech, how you doing? All right. As soon as he jumps, that's when we use the missiles. There we go. Much better. Nope. All right. We need to get out of here. Probably dead, but I'm gonna try. Nope, dead. Very dead. Oh well. And the outcome is that your 1060 is probably borked. Oh no! That's not good. But you should be able to get it fixed, right? Or replaced. I hope, at least. Because being without your shiny new video card would be a tragedy. Nobody got ready for Gamma. However, Colossus... 85, 80, oh, 90%. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, Colossus with the plays! Damn, Colossus with the plays! Very well done, Colossus. I am duly impressed. I died 4 times. That's too many. It's too many! I did good work, though. I did some of those damages. I shot him in the spaceship. I got eye for an eye. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I had 1481 MMR, and I've gained 19 from this match. Do you know what that means, ladies and gentlemen? Do you know what that means? $14.99, baby! Oh, math! Why? 81 plus 19 is not 99. One drink for the next match. Okay, Gates on once in! I don't see you online. So let's close this down, open it back up. He's not online. Okay. I'm gonna open the the bronze drop pod. Credits. Perfectly boring. Nothing wrong with them, but nothing exciting either. Silver. Ooh, what are we gonna get? More credits. Nothing wrong with that. Still good. Just not exciting. Oh my god. No guesses for Xbox? Nobody was guessing. So I was just like, I'm gonna skip it. Looks like we have to reset our client to actually see Gates on. So let's go ahead and turn this back on. What new card did I get? I must view my badge progress. I am now missing Tyrion. And I can have the first level of the Fractured Space Badge. Yeah. Got Besiege for 50% off on the Humble Bundle. Oh yeah, I forgot. I need to check and see what the Humble Bundle is. Humble Bundle! Is there anything that I want in there? What's the gate sign? Get in here. Let's see, Company of Heroes stuff. Not really my cup of tea. Click Team Fusion? What is that? I don't even know what that is. Game and software creation. Okay, it's a game creation thing.
Do I want to pay $12 to get Grim Dawn and a whole bunch of other games from the Humble Bundle Monthly? I might. Because I actually do want Grim Dawn. I'm going to keep that open. Company of Heroes 10th Anniversary Edition. Wow. That's a lot of Company of Heroes.
I think I got one more in me before I'm gonna head to bed. Because I get to go into work on Saturday. Hooray. I don't want to go into work on Saturday. Not so much because I don't want to go into work, period, but more because I have to deal with somebody I really don't like. That nobody likes. And who has a very high chance of just not showing up that day. Because they don't like me. She's a crotchety old bat. Americans get extra cash for working Saturdays? No, we don't. Generally, if you work a night shift job, you will get more because of the inconvenience. I work a night shift job, so I make a little bit extra because of the inconvenience. But, oh hey, I'm gonna play the Reaper because I haven't played the Reaper all day. But, for hourly, you are whatever your pay rate is until you exceed 40 hours. I'm gonna let him play whatever he wants. If he wants to play Pioneer, kick ass. I am not in the business of trying to tell people what to play. I will sit here and comment on that, maybe. Oh, wow. No fun allowed. No fun allowed. Wow. Here's our mascot for this round. No fun allowed. for working Saturdays? We get 150%, we get time and a half, rather, is what it's called, for overtime. Which is more than 40 hours. Time and a half for just working on Saturday? I'd work every Saturday. But you gotta remember, I'm from the capitalist paradise of Murica-stan. Mm-hmm. Yep, Modwall.
Modwall!
You know we will win. No. No game is over until it's over. I have won and lost games where one base is at 99%. Please don't beam me. Uh-oh. It's almost like I knew you were going to do that. Get fucking wrecked, Levy. Yes, jump home. This is of great benefit to you, and not to me. Alrighty. Let us accomplish goal number one. Destroy the hostile sensor. Yes. Alrighty, we're gonna get out of here. Don't shoot me, Disruptor. Don't hit on me, you silly boys. Oh, Ezreal's Reaper is so good! Why no fun allowed? Because look at our team comp. Reaper, Executioner, Brawler, Executioner, Hunter. Versus Disruptor, Black Widow, Executioner, Leviathan, Overseer. There is no fun allowed. Hey, Levy. Okay. All right, Mr. Gateson. I need you to go murder that overseer. I mean, I'm not gonna say no to your help with this Leviathan real quick. Nope. Lots of beams going around. They're very angry. Okie doke. Nope. Good, he's not paying attention to me. This is exactly what I wanted. Alright, so now let's dip out. Look at that. Look at that dip. Look at that dip. So good. Come on, Gateson, you can make it out. I have faith. You can do it. You can do it. You can make it out of there safely. Come on. Oh, he's jumping home. No, Gateson. Don't jump home. Woohoo! He still made it. so risky doing a jump home instead of a direct jump to base. But we know Gatesan does not give no fucks. It is impossible for him to give any fucks. He's too good! Alright, so Disruptor. Me and the Brawler are here. Good. Who's there? Executioner's gonna go heal. There's the other Executioner. And that's Gatesan. There's the enemy Executioner. Let's go ahead and scythe him. Alright, who's that? Executioner? There we go. Alright, that needs to be dead. So there we go. Alright, let's bust him up! Oh, he decided to do the thingy. Disarm me, that's what it's called. Alrighty. Well, there's one. Last one enemy ship down. We're about to have a second. There goes that second one. Uh-oh. And there's Gamma. Let's see if we can't myrtleize us that overseer. Yeehoo! Get scythed! Oh no! He decided to jump home. We're probably not gonna be able to catch him. But, oh man, if we just had a little bit more time. Not quite enough though. Especially while jumping. Yes, it does. Blame Ginger Gladiator right there. He is lead artist. He is responsible for pretty much the entirety of TDS. Isn't that right? I know you guys had a like a concept artist at the start, but I'm pretty sure it was get the idea of TDS and then you just ran with it from there, didn't you? And I mean, you've done like phenomenal work. Like, that's honestly one of the things that I really do like about Fractured Space, is that the ship designs aren't exactly what I would expect, which is good.
Carrier has arrived.
Thank you, Raylamar, for the follow. I do, in fact, appreciate it, as you are directly contributing towards my conquest of this planet and the establishment of the Terran Star Empire. Okay, we're gonna get close. Oh, this is gonna hurt. But we need to get out. We need to get out. Because that Black Widow actually did some damage. Oh, goodness. Wanting to spend money? No. See,
Carrier has arrived.
Al, no, thank you very much for the follow. I literally just did my shtick, so I'm not gonna put you guys through that again. But the thing is, it's not wanting to spend money that you need to be doing. It's actually spending money that you need to be doing. Terran Star Empire? Good! We could use a little bit of Empire these days. No, I saw you. No takesies, backsies. Nope, 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 nope
Be dead. Let's not bump into the asteroid right there. Let us increase our lead. Or do we go over there and help out? Well, we are going to be helping out. See, you'd think the smart move would be just go over there and help them myrtleize the enemy team, but... but just by... yeah... putting pressure on this forward base, we will actually be helping out quite a bit. Nope. Oh no! I got stuck. See, look at all these guys that came here to murder me. Look at all those guys. Do I have money? Well, awesome! Cool beans! Be sure to spend all of your spare cash on Fractured Space. Tell all your friends. Tell your friends, friends. Tell your friends, 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 friends. If they want a game that makes them feel special in the pants area, they need to be playing Fractured Space. And if they go, but it's not on consoles, then you probably shouldn't be friends with them. Nah, it's not their fault. They don't know. They don't know. Console peasants don't know. Ooh. Okay. Couple of executioners. Come on, kill that Black Widow, would you? There you go. What about your friends, 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 friends? Tell everybody. Tell your dog. Tell your grandma. Be like, hey, yo, grandma. Let's go murder the shit out of some people with some spaceships. She'd be like, hot damn, grandson, daughter, whatever. I think we should. Let me bake you some cookies first. Aw, shit, Grandma. Spaceships and cookies. Sounds like a good day. Truly, actually, one of the things that I think is super cool about Fractured Space is the fact that it is a bit slower in pace. So, there's a very good chance we're going to end up with a generally older population, which I think is pretty cool, right? This is probably... rah. Nope. Damn it, Brawler. That is not where you needed to be. You actually did a whole lot of damage to me right there. Alrighty, they want to go after the Leviathan? Let's go after the Leviathan. Ow, 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 ow. Oh god, it hurts. Gamma 2 is ours. That's what I like to hear. Okay. Only the Black Widow isn't up. Oh, only the Black Widow is up! Of course. Ah, son of a monkey. Well... I mean, I tanked all that shit, so it's bound to happen.
I also really dig the focus on the strategic rather than the 360 and Oscope. I do too, right? I like strategic games, or they can surrender. Steer Before You stated it's really not chess in space, it's more like Axis and Allies in space. You can join it on a casual level, but the tactical depth is there if you want it. Yeah, that's pretty good. Rectum? No, I'm sorry, I gotta report you for that. No. Don't cry because people surrendered. Don't cry because people surrendered. That's not cool. That is not cool. Negative attitude. Unsportsmanlike conduct. I'm sorry. But complaining that the enemy team surrendered is not what I would describe as cool beans. No, sir. No, siree, Bob. I am now north of 1500, ladies and gentlemen. I think that is a perfectly reasonable spot to end the stream today. Let's go ahead and go into my inventory. Open this golden drop pod. Not get a skin, but get some credits. It's a fun ship. Yeah. Hunter's a very good ship. It is. It really is. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining me today. Thank you very much for the follows. Thank you very much for everything, for coming and hanging out with me, for spending some of your limited time on this planet here with us, right? That's a pretty awesome thing. And I will see you lovely people on Monday, because I go into work tomorrow and then I'm gonna take Sunday off to recover. I'll stream Monday, and then I go back into work Tuesday. Hopefully they won't call me in next week on the weekend, and I can stream on the weekend. But, in any case, I will see you lovely people in the future.